And then very soon, sadhan bhakti will come in your heart, then bhav bhakti, and then prema bhakti. Tasmin mahan mukharita madhubhi charitra piyusa ses parita sarita samanti taje pivante gaadh karna tannas pisate tida moha bhava. If anyone is hearing or sinking in the river, coming from where? From the mouth of a high class of Vaishnava, like Ganges coming, no break of a stream. And he is hearing with God Karna, with
deep attachment.
This attachment, and very, very carefully. Oh, very soon he will have bhakti, prema bhakti. And no shok, bhai, moh, khuda, pipasa, nothing will come. So a preferred glorification of this sadhu sangha and hari katha has been told. But one thing more. Dharma sunishchitam, punsang visvakshen katha suja, no palya jatiratim sramai vahi kevalam. If you are doing chanting, remembering also, doing other limbs of bhakti, but you have no taste in hearing Harikatha, very sweet and powerful Harikatha, then after some time you will see you have no taste in kirtan and other things. And thus you can go down. So, anyone, whether he is attacked by oh so many anarth, but even he has taste in Harikatha, oh, he will be saved and he will be very high class of devotee. Then, one thing. One thing about Raganuga Vaidhi Bhakti, that all Raganuga cannot be Rupanuga, but all Rupanuga must be Raganuga. So in the Raganuga, Rupanuga are most high class. Very high class. And what is Rupanuga? He has written himself in Bhakti Sami Sindhu, Sant, Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya. He has written. And he has touched Mathur. Not
elaborate.
He has written himself. And in Ujjwal Nandmani, only for special devotees, it has been written. So if anyone following Bhakti Swami Sindhu, then he, whether he is Rupanuga or not, he is not Rupanuga. If he is also following Ujjwal Nandmani, Sakya Vatsalya Madhur, especially Madhur. But not following the mood of Rupa Goswami, what his mood was, then he is not Rupanu. He may be Raganu. This is the especially of Rupa Goswami. Like outside from very high class of associate of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Maru Chaitanya Mahaprabhu inspired in him all ocean of rush. And he told others, Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita Acharya, Sivas Pandit, others, Raya Ramananda, Swarup Damodar, oh, please inspire him so that he can give world my mission. So Rupa has some special considerations. So Rupanu and Raganu, there is some difference. Now, after this, we have no time, so I wanted to tell about whole sweet pastimes of Krishna. So I think it will be better that Guru Nishtha is the backbone of bhakti. If Guru Nishtha is second, then everything is born. You cannot attain bhakti. In these connections, in Srimad Bhagavatam, see, Narad and Vyasadeva Upakhyan has been told. So, I think it will be better. Van Maharaj will go tomorrow, so he should speak about Narad and Vyas and Narad Charitra.
ज्ञानशलाकया चक्षुर्नीतं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वंशाकल्पद्रुवश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यो च प्रतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई ऑफर माय हम्बल रेस्पेक्टफुल ऑब्सेंसेस टू लोटस फीट ऑफ माय गुरुपाद पद्म नित्यलीला प्रविष्टम विष्णुपाद अष्टतर सती श्री श्रीमद भक्ति वेदांत श्री भवन गोस्वी महाराज एंड उंग विष्णुपाद परिप्राजकाचार्य वर्ज अतिदंडी स्वामी श्रीमद भक्ति वेदांत श्री नारायण गोस्वी महाराज एंड ऑल सन्यासी वृंद ब्रह्मचारी वृंद वैष्णव वृंद मातृवृंद आई एंड ऑल्सो प्रेजेंटेड ऑल माई रेस्पेक्टफुल गेस्ट गुरुदेव ऑर्डर मी टू डिस्कस अबाउट द conversation between Narad and Vyas. That's called Vyas and Narad Sambhav. In Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, the conversation between Sutta Goswami and Sanukadi Rishi. Sanukadi Rishi, they also asked Sutta Goswami, how did Srimad Bhagavatam manifested in this Kali Yuga? So that time, Sutta Goswami, but he discuss about the Narad Vyasa Sangvad.
He telling louder. Go on.
Narad Vyasa Sangvad, this is very important. Vyasadeva Goswami, he was the Saptavish avatar. And he manifested first Vedas. And he divided four types of Vedas, Rig, Sam, Yajur, and Atharva. But very difficult to understand these Vedas. Very complicated. Not general people could understand these Vedas. Then he also manifested the Puranas, a Upanishad, 11,000.
Oh, Brahma Sutra.
Vedas, then Brahma.
Essence of all the Vedas. That Brahma Sutra.
Then,
but it was also very
and this Brahma Sutra also very complicated, not very easy to understand. Athato Brahma Jigyasa Sastra Janitva, very difficult to understand this small, the quotation, these things, not so easy to understand. 545 sutras he manifested, but this is very difficult to understand. Then he also again manifested that is called the Upanishad, 11,080 Upanishad. But prominent Upanishad, 18th Upanishad, ninth Upanishad prominent. Katha, Keno, Mandukka, Mandubbad, or Chandak Upanishad in this.
Don't elaborate.
So then he also very difficult to understand. There are internal meaning of this position. There he also manifested the Puranas, Asattvic, Rajasic and Tamasic Puranas. In this way, he discussed all these things.
Also he did Mahabharata.
And also Pancham Vedam, Mahabharatam, Itihasam, Pancham Vedanam. Pancham Vedam, fifth Vedas, that's called Itihas, that's called Mahabharatam. But still, his mind is very disturbed. One day, he was sitting in Sammak Prayas on the bank of the river of Saraswati. He could not find out the disturbance of his mind. Gurudev in this context explained, as like the patient, Rogi, patient himself cannot recognize his own
disease.
So he has to go to the doctor. Then doctor will diagnose his disease and will give the best medicine. In the same way, Vasudev, his mind was very disturbed. He was thinking, what is the cause of the disturbance of his mind? In the meantime, Narada Rishi arrived. That is called Sadguru. Kono bhagge kono jibir saddha jodi hoy tobe soi jib sadhu sanga koroi brahmanda bhramite kono bhagwan jib guru krishna prasade pai bhakti lata abhis. Who has extreme sukriti, then he will get association of high class bona fide exalted guru. So in this way, Narada Rishi, he arrived. Then Vasudev, he stood up his asana. Just now when Gurudev is coming, all the devotees, they also stood up and also do Guru Puja, Vasu Puja. In the same way, Narada Vasudev, he also worships his lotus feet. And when Narada Rishi seated in his asana, then Vasudev sit down in it. And that day Narada Rishi spontaneously, he told, hey Vasudev, I know the cause of disturbance of your mind. That means those are Sadguru. He knows the heart of his disciple. That is called Sadguru. That is called Trikalabdha. That means he knows present, past and future. He knows everything. Because Gurudev, he is non-defense from Lord. Saksa dhritya samastra sastri ruktastha bhav badaiva sadvi kintu prabhurya priyavatasya bande gurusi charanar bindu. Acharya Mang Vijaya Ramanya Kahichit. Many slokas also discussing Sadguru. So in this way, Narada Rishi told, hey Vasudev, I know the cause of disturbance of your mind. Because you manifested many Ved, Puran, Upanishad and specially Puranas. Those who are reading and hearing this Grantha, and their mind completely what? Confused. All the audience, they confused. What is the absolute truth? That means you did not clearly explain in your Grantha books who is the supreme personality of Godhead, who is Sang Bhagavan. If you read Vishnu Puran, you see Vishnu, he is the supreme personality of Godhead. If you read Kurma Puran, Kurma Dev, he is the supreme personality of Godhead. Who is the supreme personality of Godhead? There are many. Who is he? So he did not come. So every audience, their mind completely what? Confused. Who is the Supreme Bhagavan? Sang Bhagavan. Who is? Even Ramchandra, he is Sang Bhagavan or not? Even in this way. So again, another things in your Puranas, you explain the four things: dharma, artha, kama, and moksha. That time Vasudev, his Narada Rishi, he quoted one verse. Very nice. जथा धर्म दयश्च मुनि वर्जुन कीर्तिता न तथा वासुदेव महिमानुवर्तिता. Narada Rishi told, hey Vasudev, though you explain about the dharma, artha and kama moksha in the different your grantha books, but what is that dharma? Vasudeva katha ruchi. If you perform the varnashram dharma, but if you not following not perform bhajan and sadhan, that varnashram dharma is useless. Chaitanya Charitamrita Krishna Das very clearly. Tari varanashrami jadi krishna nahi bhaje sasa karma karite sahi rourave padi mori maje.
Even those who are following the all the rules and regulations of the society, varna and ashram dharma, but you're not following, you're not performing bhajan and sadhan, they are varnashram dharma, you are useless. Urabe padi maje, you will go in hell. Very clearly. Explain this, varnashram. So this varna ashram dharma, you explain in this way. Another dharma artha economical development. Now what was all they are thinking? How we develop the economy? Artha, dharma, artha, kama, sense gratifications. You are explained in this way. That is called dana punna. Then you will go heaven, circle of, and you enjoy more and more sense gratifications. This is called the artha. Moksha, mukti, vasana. These are two liberation, mukti, vasana. But this is not the goal, supreme goal of the living entities. So this is all. And other things, though you discuss Krishna Lila Charit Katha, different old Puranas, and Garga Sanhita, very nice, beautiful, also Krishna Lila Charit Katha. But if they be not in sequence, not in stage by stage, these things you did not explain. And other things, you do not clearly explain what is our supreme goal. It is for this reason. Then Vasudev told, what to do now? Then Narada Rishi told, listen.
He told also, have you told in that Vatsalya Yashodam I banded him?
You also discuss this is Puranas, this is Krishna Lila Charit Katha. Did you describe the how did Mother Yashoda bind Krishna with the supreme personality of Godhead? Oh, I did not.
I don't know, Gurudev.
I don't know, Gurudev. How to do this? Then again, Krishna, how did he also perform his sakharas? Relish the sakharas. Did you describe? No, I did not. Then, even you, did you explain about the Krishna? Krishna, who is the supreme personality of Godhead, he performed the sweet rasa lila with him. And not only this, how the because Shastra also saying all Ved Puranas will describe. This is the general of these things. All the devotees, they are searching to Lord. This is the general. And like Dhruva, Prahlad, they are searching to Lord, Bhagavad Kosha. They are doing these things. But why you did not explain? Lord with his prem, divine love, he is searching his high class devotee. Vanam Vanantaram, Sukhdev Goswami Pad, very clearly explained Krishna. He used to go herding the cows. One forest to another forest means is what? Krishna is running behind the Braj Gopis. And Krishna is crying for them. And if you also you did not explain, na parahang nirvatam samjitam sa sadhu pitta vivadhaya sa guma jada jama durjana yusang vischa prati jatu sadhuna. This thing you should explain. This is the frame. Even you were not explaining, they have Krishna, have high class devotees as such as Uddhav, how to glorify about the lotus feet of gopis. Very nice, beautiful these things. Venugit, Brahmargit, Rasgita. This is the topmost things. You did not explain these things. This is the topmost things. But your prayer is going. Just yesterday Gurudev or just now Gurudev told Sadhatu Madrakka Mahabhav. Are these things? So these things you did not explain. So you should explain these things. Then Vasudev, he told Gurudev, how will I realize these things? Then Vasudev, he told, Narada, he told, it is simple. Karma, gun, gyan, jog, tapasya, by the performing of karma, gyan, and jog, and tapasya, austerity, you cannot realize this Krishna Lila. You manifest the Srimad Bhagavatam, latest Puranam, Srimad Bhagavatam. But how will I manifest the latest Puranam, Srimad Bhagavatam? Then Narada Rishi quoted one part. Bhakti, bhakti, jogena manasi, sammaka pranihite amale, apasat purusam purana, mayancha tatapasrayam. That's nice, beautiful, this law. Bhakti, jogena, only by the performing of honored devotional service to Lord. Guru and Krishna, bhakti yogena manasa, सम्मक प्रणीते अमले अपसत पुरुषं कृष्ण बाय द पावर ऑफ भक्ति योग व्यासदेव ही डायरेक्ट सो कृष्णस ऑल ब्यूटीफुल पास्ट टाइम्स सम्मक प्रणीते अमले अपसत पुरुषं पूर्ण पुरुषं
पूर्ण वेंट इन समाधि एंड इन समाधि ही सॉ everything as if any fruit is keeping here and he sees all the pastimes from beginning to end.
He saw this lila when everything is bhakti yoga and one something. Purna Purush, when Krishna is Purna Purush, Purna Purush Krishna, which called the supreme personality of Godhead Bhagavan. So when he remains with Srimati Radhika. सैमे रमा रमणम सुंदरता वरिष्ठ सौंदर्य मोहित समस्त जगत जनस्य सैमस्य वामवद्धतु कदाह ताम इंद्रावरम भजाम 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 कृपा गोस्वामी पा वेरी क्लियरली एक्सप्लेन दिस थिंग हु इज कॉल्ड पूर्ण पुरुष कृष्ण व्हेन इज कृष्ण पूर्ण पुरुष अपूर्ण पुरुष कृष्ण देयर हु इज इनकार्नेशन आर कम नारायण टू अदर्स दैट्स इज अपूर्ण पूर्ण पुरुष कृष्ण व्हेन कृष्ण रिमेंस with his internal potency sarv shakti sarvini srimati radhika mahabhav sarvini srimati radhika and he krishna completely manifested his purnata completely found in rasa dance with srimati radhika this thing so in this way Vyasadeva he realized this thing and then he also clearly explained these things the srimad bhagavatam first canto he explained very clearly the krishna कृष्ण Then last he also explained Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead and Swayam Bhagavan. Then your dharma, artha, kama, moksha. This is not our aim and object. Our object only what is called Govipayam.
He also saw that jiv is superior than Maya, but even entangled in Maya.
Yes. How the jivas? Even he saw the Maya. Maya the apasrita. That means durasrita. Maya she remains very far away from Krishna. Jaha Krishna taha nahi Maya randakar. Where is Krishna? There is no Maya. Maya she is very far away. Viracca manaya. Srimad Bhagavatam very clearly explained. Maya she is very shy and she remains very far away from Krishna. But to Vyasadeva he also saw these things with his samadhi dasa. Samadhi stage, how the jivas entangled by the Maya and how jivas also will become free from Maya. These things also. How will it become free from Maya? This thing also discussed in Ekadas, 11th canto, Navajagendra Sangvad. What is
called?
Guru Devata? Ditya Abhi Niveshata Sat in this slope. Guru Devata Atma. When one should completely surrender lotus feet of bona fide Guru, that is called Vikrita Vasu. Sold out
animal.
When we will be completely surrender lotus feet of Gurudev, then we will be able to practice the unalloyed personal service to Lord. This thing Vyasadeva very clearly explained, and he also very sequentially these things Krishna lila everything this way, and in this way Srimad Bhagavatam manifested. And shall we
Now, Vyasadeva saw in his trance, and then those who are ajanata don't know all these things. They are ignorant. For them, what he saw in his trance, he wrote down. First it was in Chatushloki Bhagavata. Narayan has given to Brahma Brahma has given to Narad, and Brahma told Narad, elaborate it. He told it to Vyas, and he told Vyas again, you should elaborate. And then how he was elaborated, he has told. Then he wrote Srimad Bhagavatam. Those who don't know, ignorant, they are attached to worldly, all these things. Lokasya ajanato vidvansya kriya sastvata sanghitayam. Like this. And then he called his son Vaitrik Sukadeva Goswami, who was detached from worldly things from birth. And then he taught him all Srimad Bhagavatam. And then how Parikshit, being a very powerful king, he can also check the influence of Kali. But how, anyhow, a course came from a Brahmin that after 7 days you will be bitten by a takshak, by a snake, very poisonous, and you will die. Why? Parikshit Maharaj, so very pious, religious person. He was Brahman Bhakta, Rishi Bhakta, very powerful king. Why he did so? Oh, by the wish of Krishna. By Yog Maya influence he did. He cannot do, never, a person like him. He cannot insult a Brahmin like Samikrishi. But he did. It means by he is so lucky that Krishna has saved him in the womb of her mother, his mother. And now he wants that Srimad Bhagavat should come through him. These glorious things will be on his head. So to give them this glory by the influence of Krishna, Yogamaya, he insulted that Brahmin, and he told that after 6-7 days, his son told, after 7 days, a snake will come and bite and you will die. At once he gave up his kingdom, everything, and he fasting till death. Not drinking water, not letting no urine pass, nothing. And in the meantime, from whole world, all the great rishis, maharshis, like Narad, Vyas, Gautam, Vasishtha, so many high exalted devotees, at once came. How they came? There was no
telephone,
nothing, no computer, nothing. But they knew all these things. At once they came. And in the meantime, Sukadeva Goswami also came. All gave him honor. He was quite naked. Very beautiful, young. Ladies were saying that, oh, he is a mad person. And they will give him dust on his body. And boys giving him some stones on his body. And when he came nearer, and all council stood up and honored him, they run away from there. And then Parikshit Maharaj asked, what is the aim and object of the life? How anyone can be happy? Please tell me. Anyone is going to die just now in a moment. He is ready to die. what he should do at once. And those who will die tomorrow, day after tomorrow, after 1 year, after 10 years, after 100 years, after 200 years, what they should do. This was meant to question. And after that he also asked about more than 12 questions. And what Sukadeva Goswami answered and what Parikshit Maharaj asked, this is Bhagavatam. Why Krishna appeared in this world? What was the reason? Oh, not only one reason. So many reasons. First, so many kings in Treta Yuga, like Ravana and his associates, Daitya Dano, they were killed in that battle. All the demons became very powerful Kshatriya Raja. And they were doing so many things that they were burden of earth. So earth requested Brahma, and Brahma with Shankar and all demigods went to Kheersagar. And they prayed, Prabhu, you should come. And an aerial voice came, oh, my Prabhu knows all. Kheerupdasai Vishnu told that my Prabhu, his Prabhu means Krishna himself, knows this. Very soon he will descend to this world. All the demigods with their wives, they should go to Gokul. They should take birth to serve Krishna and to serve Radhika. And then all the gods with Brahma, they return back. And for this reason, to fulfill the desire of all demigods and to take the burden of and that is jada jada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutthanam adharmasya tadatmanam sriyamyam paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya to duskritam dharma santhapnarthaya sampoam. This was also reason. And you know that once Narada was going anywhere and he saw in a Mansarovar, oh, some aspara with son of Kubair, Nalkubar, Manigriv. Naked, they were playing in, enjoying in a pond. Narada was going by side, all the ladies came out of the pond and they took their clothes and did pranam to Narada. But that poor drunkards, they did not. They began to abuse that girls and also to Narada. Why he has come in this side? There were so many ways he should have gone. Oh Narada, now you have become like trees. Oh, at once you should become tree. Then they began to at once become a tree. Then they were praying, oh Prabhu, we have done offense. Please excuse us. Oh, what I have told, you will be in Dwapar Yug, in the last of Dwapar Yug, you will be tree and Krishna will descend in this world and he will touch you and you delivered. For this also Satyam Abhidhatum Nija Bhakta Bhasita. What? Sanak Sanandan Sanatan Sanat Kumar has told, they have caused Jaivijaya. Oh, for three
lifetime.
Life. You should go to world and be Daitya Dano. Then they became first Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyaksha, then Raman, Kumbhakarna, and then Shishupal Dutta. So Satyam Abhidham, to follow, to do Satya, through the words of
Oh, that Munis. Oh, Putana. In his previous Janma, he was previous birth. She was the daughter of Bali Maharaj Ratnamala. When she saw that Baman Maharaj came, Baman Dev came in the council. Oh, seeing his beauty, he thought, oh, if he would have been my son, very good. But when he became the Vikram and took his whole kingdom, even himself, and he binded him in
snake rope.
Snake rope, then, oh, if he will be my son, I will give him poison. Oh, to Satyam Abhidhatum. For this reason, he also, that Putana became, Ratnamala became Putana, and he was going to kill Krishna by poison in the disguise of a mother. Krishna told, oh, you have come here like mother? Oh, he get that gati. You know that Devaki has six more sons before Krishna and Baldev. For them also, big history. Also, Krishna descended to do Aswarja and Madhurja Mai sweet pastime, so that forever all will hear these sweet pastimes and be liberated and will have Krishna prem easily. For this, you know, Dandakaran Nivasi, Rishi, they were thinking to how we can have be gopi for that move. And they saw Ramchandra and they prayed. And by his mercy, they became Dandakaranyavasi gopi who were doing Katyayani Vrata. So, for them, he came. Also, Janakpuri, all the princes, they wanted to marry with Ram. And then Ram told that, oh, in Krishna Lila you will be gopi and there I will fulfill. All this Swarna Sita,
golden
Sita, each year Ram used to make them. And they used to become like real.
Alive.
But they wanted to be with Ram. Oh, he told that, oh, in Krishna Lila you should be gopi. Also to show, Nanda kim akarot, Brahman, say are you Mahodayam, Jasodata,
Mahabhaga, Papojasastana.
Or to show this world that in the avatar of Ram, no one can bind him. Mother Kausalya could not, father died, and here Jasoda. Though Krishna was Supreme Lord, very powerful, but he banded him. No history, not anywhere written. You know that Krishna has come to establish the glory more than Dwarka queens to establish. Anyone should not think that, oh, like Sri Sampradaya, they are quarreling with our Sampradaya in Galta Gaddi of Jaipur. And Baldev Prabhu went there and defeated. They were telling that Rukmini can come with Krishna. How this Radhika will come? And he cut it all argument. Then told us, this is, have you Brahma Sutra?
Commentary of Brahma
commentary? Sutra. Oh, we have not. Bhagavati. We think that Srimad Bhagavati itself the commentary of Brahma Sutra. Oh, we want to see. And in one night, Gobind told that, I am telling you should read.
Right.
And then, it is Govinda Bhashya. So, to establish this also. Also, यू नो अन्याराधितो नूनम न पारे हम निर्वध्य संयुजन टू एस्टैब्लिश द ग्लोरीज ऑफ गोपीज आई कैन नॉट रिपे यू फॉर थाउजेंड एंड थाउजेंड ऑफ बर्थ्स आई कैन नॉट सो प्लीज बी सैटिस्फाइड बाय योर गुड क्वालिटीज सो एस्टैब्लिश एंड मोर देन अन्याराधितो नूनम भगवान हरिश्वर जन्नो बिहाय गोविंद टू एस्टैब्लिश दैट दो चंद्रावली एंड अदर ललिता विशाखा श्यामला चंद सो मेनी बट राधिका इज सुपीरियर टू एस्टैब्लिश ऑल दीज थिंग ऑल्सो अनुग्रहाय भूतानाम मानुषीन देहम आश्रित भजते तादृशी क्रीड़ा जस उत्पादक भवे दैट आई एम डूइंग इफ आई विल डू I will take my all sweet pastimes from Guru Vrindavan here in this world. This Vrindavan, Bhauma Vrindavan. Then all will hear. So many will see. So many will hear. If anyone is yadi Krishna ke viruddhi bhi hai.
Someone opposite to Krishna. Opposing to Krishna.
Bahirmukh is his Bahirmukh. Even they will be Sanmukh. If anyone is praying, then he will go to Lok Vrindavan. So from different kinds of devotees to fulfill their desire, he came also. If even anyone will hear Bhajate Tadrashi Kida, what he had done, always remembering, then very soon he will have Krishna prem. Vikriditam prajpad bhajya idam cha vishno suniyat anupsadhaya atayir varniyet ja bhaktim param bhagavatim. First by hearing, by saddha, hearing all these sweet pastimes of Krishna, especially this Ras Leela, then he will have first calm. What come? Oh, that Krishna kama nuga bhakti. And then come will go away. What come? Lust and all these will go. Dhira, those who have a strong belief that by hearing all first bhakti will come and lust will go away. Oh, they are dhira. And they don't believe in this. Oh, first anarth should go away and then we will hear. Then this is offense. So for so many reasons he came. Now, how Krishna took birth in this world? In Mathura and in Gokul. And how he reached to Gokul. Peter Man Kirtan. Where is Sudevi? From other day you should sit nearby. Yo.
Sarvabhauma ache.
Kaun sir?
One day walking, Liberong Road, we meet Sabran.
Where he is?
Sarvabhauma here. Sarvabhauma.
You have your
yes.
Anish hai. Kutha hai. Aur jab jabe aante hai na ki. Oh.
Puttana.
This song.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One day while walking down life's long road, we met a man sat front row. Prabhupada was his name. He was chanting the holy name. He said, "Come with me, my daughters and sons. Your spiritual journey just begun. Chant the holy names of the Lord, and all desirable things will, and all desirable things will, and all desirable things will be yours. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare. Coming our way, and we know that your love is here to stay. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Your spiritual journey has just just begun. Chant the holy names of the Lord, and all desirable things will, and all desirable things will, and all desirable things will be yours. Hare Krishna, Hare
Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Namo Namaha Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sivasani Gaudu Bhaktivinoda. So first of all, I offer my millions of obeisances, lotus feet of Gurudev, to present Vaishnava Sannyasis, also ladies and gentlemen, Vaishnavis, Vaishnavis. So Gurudev has given me some instruction to discuss the appearance of...
Come here.
Don't fear.
So Gurudev has ordered me to speak about the appearance of Krishna. So Srimad Bhagavatam in 10th canto, after describing the appearance of the other incarnations of Krishna, Sukadev Goswami, in order to please Parikshit Maharaj, began descriptions of the appearance of the Supreme Lord. Already Gurudev has described some of the reasons, but anugrahaya bhaktanam manusam dayam asritam. But one of the main reasons is by hearing these pastimes, then the mind of the devotee will become very, very fixed on the Lord, and bhajan will be possible. So the appearance of Krishna is also shrouded in mystery in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Guru Maharaj says that something very beautiful should not be revealed openly. Just like a lady, when she wears a very fine cloth, she appears even more attractive. In the same way, the appearance of Krishna is not completely directly described, but Sukadev Goswami has given in a hidden way. But who can see? Because the Srimad Bhagavatam is the Paramahamsa Sanghitam. It is only understood by the pure Vaishnavas who are free from material contamination. Therefore, in order to understand the Srimad Bhagavatam, by your independent reading, you will not be successful. Therefore, Sri Swarup Damodara Goswami has said, Yaha Bhagavata Pare Vaishnavarastani Akanta Asraya Kore Sri Chaitanya Charani. If you want to understand the Srimad Bhagavatam, then you have to sit at the feet of a Vaishnava who has taken complete shelter of the feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then you can understand. So what I have heard from Gurudev and the Vaishnavas, I'll try to my utmost to try to repeat that thing. So we have already heard that Brahma went to the shore, the Kiradaksai, went to the shore of the Kirsaga, and there he prayed to Bhagawan. There a voice appeared in the heart of Lord Brahma from Kiradaksai Vishnu. Soon, my Prabhu, means my Lord, from whom even I come from, will appear on the earth planet at the end of Dwapara Yuga. Therefore, Brahma was ordered all the demigods should appear in Nandagokul, and also in Mathura, in order to facilitate the pastimes of Krishna. Therefore, Krishna's Guru Jana means his superiors, like his mother and father, his teachers, etc., they appeared first in this material world. So we should not think that Goloka Vrindavan descends to this world. No. Braja Vrindavan is always present in this material world. Sometimes it manifests, sometimes it unmanifests, according to the desire of the Lord. So Kams Maharaj, he was a big Rakshas demon. Therefore, on the day of the marriage of his sister, Devaki, he was so happy at the marriage of his sister. He was driving the chariot and very pleased. Who would not be pleased on the marriage of the sister? That time a voice came from heaven. Foolish Kamsa, you don't know that the eighth child of your sister will be the cause of your death. Then Kamsa began shaking. Where there's no smoke, there's fire. A stitch in time saves nine. Therefore, he took his sword and went to take off the head of his sister. That time, Vasudev Maharaj, he prayed, "Oh Kams, don't be foolish. She will not be the cause of your death. The eighth child will be the cause of your death." But Kamsa was still determined to put Devaki to death. Therefore, Vasudev Maharaj promised, "Don't be fear. I promise, as each child is born to you, I will deliver him to you. Therefore, there is no need for you to kill. Why on such an auspicious day you will perform an inauspicious act like killing your daughter, your own sister?" Therefore, Kams Maharaj was pacified. When the first child appeared from the womb of Devaki, then Vasudev Maharaj, in order to fulfill his promise, he gave the first child to Kams Maharaj. Then Kams, he felt some affection for his nephew. He returned it back. But then Narad became worried. Narad wanted to make sure that Kamsa made as many and many offenses as possible that would make sure that he was finished and also would quickly bring the descent of the Lord. Just like when a cup becomes more and more water, and then it overflows, Narad wanted that Kamsa should quickly finish himself. Therefore, Narad Muni came to Kams Maharaj and said, Kams Maharaj said, "Welcome, Gurudev." Because Narad Muni was such a Vaishnav, he knew Kams is one of the main pivots of Krishna Lila. Therefore, even Narad Muni used to go to visit him. And Sri Narad Muni's mind was so generous, even demons like Kamsa used to worship him. Therefore, Kams Maharaj said, "Oh, welcome, Gurudev." He said, "Welcome me after. I am very hungry. Please bring me some sweets. 8 pieces of peda, one famous Mathura sweet." Then he brought 8 pieces. Then Narad Muni said, "Give me the 8th one." Then Kams said, "How do I know which one is the 8th one?" In the same way Narad said, "The demigods are very tricky. How do you know which is the 8th son of Devaki?" And without explaining, he disappeared. Then Kams could understand, yes, the demigods are maybe tricky. Maybe they begin counting from 6. 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Therefore, I better take care. Therefore, he took that child and dashed it upon the stone and killed it. Then he put Vasudev and Devaki in the jail and began torturing them. And as one child was born, one after another, then Kams killed them. It described, even though they were the brothers of the Supreme Lord, because in their previous life they had made offense to Lord Brahma, when Brahma was chasing behind his daughter, that time the 6 sons of Marichi were laughing, "Ha, how shameless fellow." But Lord Brahma is not an ordinary soul. He is liberated, he is pure devotee. Therefore, this some instruction. One should not sit on the same seat as one's own mother or sister, because one may be attracted by sex desire. Therefore, they made offense and were cursed to be killed by their own uncle. Uncle. Kams killed them.
Yes.
Anyway. So, the 6 sons of Marich were killed. The 6 sons of Vasudev Maharaj were killed. Then appeared the 7th child in the womb of Devaki Mata. Therefore, Bhagavatam describes that this was a miscarriage. But really, Guru Maharaj describes also, this was not a miscarriage. That Balaram, situated in Mathura, Vasudev Nandan, who appeared in the womb of Devaki, he stayed there for eight months. Then at the end of 8 months, that partial expansion of Balaram, who was there in Mathura, by the influence of Yogamaya, he was transformed into the womb of Rohini in Gokul. And there he stayed another 10 months in the womb. Therefore, Bhagavatam described it was a miscarriage, but actually it was not a miscarriage. The partial expansion of Balaram in Mathura transferred himself and merged in the womb with the original Rohini Nandan situated in Nanda Gokul. Then came the 8th child, Of course, Kamsa, being very fortunate, he was one of the first persons to know that Krishna would appear in this world. Therefore, he was constantly absorbed in thought, the Supreme Lord will kill me, the Supreme Lord will kill me. Therefore, he achieved perfection by thinking of the Lord out of fear. Therefore, Kamsa, he was waiting as that child appeared in 8 months. Then as the pregnancy developed and developed, Devaki became even more beautiful. In fact, a great effulgence was coming from her. We should not think that Devaki gave birth to Krishna just like an ordinary man and woman through seminal discharge. This is not a fact. Vasudeva Maharaj, who always carries the Supreme Lord in his heart, he transferred the Lord in his heart into the womb of Devaki by mantra. Just like tomorrow, many devotees will have the good fortune to take initiation. At initiation, the spiritual master transforms the form of Sri Radha Raman, Radha Krishna, that is in his heart. He transfers that into the heart of the disciple through mantra. So this is not any mundane man and woman relationship. Therefore, as Kamsa saw the effulgence of Devaki, he became more and more fearful, more and more afraid. Described, even the demigods used to come to the womb, to the prison house, and offer prayers, not to Devaki directly, but to the womb of Devaki. Therefore, as due course of time, on midnight, on the Ashtami, at very dark, then Devaki gave birth, the Supreme Lord appeared from the womb of Devaki. As a 16-year-old boy with four hands, in one hand he carried club, discus, in the bottom two hands he carried a lotus flower and a conch shell for offering benedictions. Then because Mathura is situated halfway between Vrindavan and Dwarka, there is a mixture of moods. There is a mixture of opulence, but there is also a mixture of sweetness in